and Abraham became unstoppable. I come to declare to you, from this day, you become unstoppable. You become unstoppable in your career. Maritally, you become unstoppable. Can I hear somebody shout a believing amen? Can I hear somebody shout a believing amen? Say, I become unstoppable. I become unstoppable. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Stop him anymore. Now listen to me. He took a supernatural intervention such that what stopped his father wasn't strong enough to stop him. Are you still here with me? Are you still here with me? Whatever is stopping people in your family, whatever is stopping people in your neighborhood, whatever is stopping people, powers that say nobody goes beyond this realm, today, by the anointing of the Holy Ghost, they scatter over your life. And you will finish well. You will get to your kingdom. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. My God. My God. The voice of God. Hear me. If you read the book of Nehemiah, the book of Ezra, you will see that there was a time they stopped the building of the temple. But the Bible says that the prophets of God came and they began to prophesy. And then the work that was stopped started all over again. Are you still here with me? So whenever there is a stopping power, what will God do? He will release his word through his servant the prophets, so that whatever has stopped will begin to rise up and walk again. And I prophesy to you that business is rising up, that career is rising up, that business is rising up. This year, that power that is stopping you from marriage is broken. Jesus, my God, I love the way Isaiah puts the voice of God. I believe strongly that God's voice is coming this morning in Isaiah chapter 30, and I read from verse 29. He says, ye shall have a song as in the night when the holy solemnity is kept, and gladness of heart as when one goeth with a pipe to come into the mountain of the Lord, to the mighty one of Israel. Read verse 30 with me, everybody. One, two, go. And the Lord shall cause his glorious voice to be heard, and shall show the lightning down of his hand with the indignation of his anger, and with the flame of the devouring fire, and scattering, and tempest, and hailstone. Verse 31, read verse 31 with me. One, two, go. For through the voice of the Lord shall the Assyrian be beaten down, which smote with a roar. Today, by the voice of the Lord, every Assyrian against your destiny, they are beaten down. 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 In the name of Jesus. My God, have your seat for a minute. We'll read one more scripture and then we'll pray. I love to read the way he puts the voice of the Lord again. In Isaiah chapter 29. Is somebody sensing the presence of God here this morning? Oh my God, I sense God is doing a work here. There is a work of remembrance. There is someone here this morning. You thought the Lord has forgotten you. And you've been asking, Lord, am I still in your program? The Lord asked me to tell that individual, oh yes, I have not changed my mind from the very first day I spoke to you. I am still committed to it. Return and then begin to move on with faith. I'm committed to what I said from the very beginning. Hallelujah. Look at what the Bible says concerning the voice of the Lord. He says,
from verse 3, Psalms 29, from verse 3, he said, the voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thundereth. The Lord is upon many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaketh the cedars. Yea, he breaketh the Lord, breaketh the cedars of Lebanon. He maketh them also to skip like a calf. Lebanon and Syria like a young unicorn. The voice of the Lord divided the flames. The voice of the Lord shaketh the wilderness. The Lord shaketh the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord maketh the hinds to come and discover in the forest, and in his temple doth everyone speak of his glory. The Lord sitteth upon the floor. Yea, the Lord sitteth king forever. The Lord will give strength unto his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace. Hear me, child of God, this morning. The voice of the Lord is coming into every area of your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh my God, when the choir was leading today, they were quoting from Zechariah chapter 4. And we're going to read that, the last chapter, and we're going to pray this morning. Now I want you to prepare your heart. These 3 days will be awesome. I told you today is to lay the foundation in prayer, in teaching. Then Monday, Tuesday is going to be ministration all through. All through. It's going to be ministration. Zechariah chapter 4. Let's read this and then we close. Zechariah chapter 4. Are you still here this morning? If you're still here, shout a big amen.
Amen.
Hey, the powers in Haran disturbed Terah. But when the voice came to Abraham, the voice of the Lord moved him forward to Canaan. Unto Canaan they went, and unto Canaan they came. Zechariah 4, I read from verse 6. He said, then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. Who art thou, O great mountain, before Zerubbabel? Thou shalt become a plain. And he shall bring forth the headstone thereof with shouting, crying, grace, grace unto him. Now let me explain that. Now you see, what is the headstone? The headstone is the finishing stone where you are building a house. Now let me read from other translations of the Bible. Praise the Lord. I'm going to read from the New Living Translation. Verse 7. He said, nothing, not even a mighty mountain, will stand in Zerubbabel's way. It will become a level plain before him. Now, and when Zerubbabel sets the final stone on the temple, of the temple in place, the final stone, that is when the work is completed. When the work is completed. The work had been delayed for years. He said, the people will shout, may God bless it. May God bless it. Now, this is actually what happened if you read from Ezra, from Nehemiah, also from Haggai, and from Zechariah. Now, those four books were talking about the same event. This is what happened. The temple work had been abandoned. And they just couldn't continue the temple. And when they couldn't continue the temple, God raised the prophets, Zechariah, and then Haggai, and they went to the people and they began to prophesy to the people. They were speaking the word of God to the people. And this Bible says in the book of Zechariah chapter 1, he said, then rose up Zerubbabel the son of Shealtiel and Joshua the son of Josedech and the remnant of the people, and they began to build the work. The work that has stopped. What made them to build it? When prophecy began to come to them. They were prophesying. They were speaking the word of God. Speaking the word of God to the people. And the people rose up. And the Bible says that there is no mountain, no power that can stop the work that Zerubbabel is doing. The mountain will become a great plain. He said, and when he has put the finishing stone on top of the temple, the people will shout, grace, grace unto him. In other words, this is exactly what happened. When the prophets prophesied, Zerubbabel, Joshua,
And the rest of the people got to the place where the temple was, and they were declaring, grace, grace, grace. Because it's not my mind, it's not my power, it's by my spirit. They began to invoke the supernatural. Are you still here? Because it will take beyond the natural to finish the work of the building. Hear me. There are times in life that it will take beyond the natural to finish what you are doing. It will take beyond the natural to settle that marital situation, to have that breakthrough in the place of the fruit of, in the fruit of the womb. It will take more than the natural. What do? You go there and you begin to shout what? Grace. Let somebody say grace. Shout it loud, I say grace. Shout it again, say grace. Oh my God. In other words, you get to that place where you have been stuck, and instead of complaining, and instead of crying, what do you say? Grace. You go to that company where there have been problems. What do you shout there? Grace. The Bible didn't say you will say grace, and you will shout grace and grace unto it. You will invoke the supernatural upon it. Can I hear somebody shout grace? Oh, concerning your marital life, shout grace. Concerning that next level, shout grace. Concerning that finance, shout grace. Let somebody shout grace. Shout in grace. Shout in grace. Shout in grace. 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 Hallelujah. Shouting grace and grace unto him. Verse 9. The hands of Zerubbabel have laid the foundation of this house. His hands shall also finish it. Rise on your feet with me this morning. I sense grace is in the house. I sense grace is in the house. I have been sent this morning to usher in the voice of God. The same voice that moved Abraham against all the opposition of Haran. The same voice that broke what from Abraham's father, Terah, couldn't break. That same voice of the Lord is coming upon somebody today, and grace will be released. Now, you see, I do not know what might be your need this morning. It might be a project you need to complete. It might be, you know, a business you need to sign. It might be a house you need to finish. It might be an academic situation. It might be a financial situation. It might be a health situation this morning. It might be fruit of the womb, marital breakthrough. But the supernatural is coming. Hear me. People that want to finish well, they value the supernatural. Are you still here with me? I want you to open up your voice to God this morning and talk to the Lord and say, Father, I receive grace, grace, grace to finish and to finish well. In the name of Jesus. I receive that grace now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Now mention that area to God. It may be job, it might be marriage, it might be finances. Let me just mention it to God. I say, Lord, it is in this area of my life. It is in this area of my life. I receive grace, grace, grace to finish it this morning. In Jesus' precious name we pray. My God, let's all eyes be closed. I want to pray for you. There are 13 individuals here this morning. The Lord just showed it to me. The anointing of God is coming so strong over your life. There are powers that have stood. And these powers, you know, they've been there for generations. And they have said to you that no one in your entire lineage has crossed this boundary. I saw 13 individuals. And you've been attempting to cross it. And they're accusing you. And they're saying to you, no, you can't cross this boundary. No, we won't allow that. We won't allow that. But I hear the Lord saying this morning that this morning deliverance has come.
Amen.
Deliverance has come. Deliverance has come. Spirit of God, wherever those 13 individuals are, I pray for them. I ask for the release of your power. Oh my God. Jesus, thank you. 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 Yes, all over this house, all over this house, grace is being released. Grace is being released. Grace is being released. Grace is being released. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. People are crossing marital hurdles. People are crossing financial hurdles. Oh my God. Oh my God. Grace is being released. Grace is being released. Receive it right now.